question on the manufacturing problem. Now, a manufacturing company makes two types of teaching aids A and B of mathematics of class 12th, A and B. Each type of aid requires 9 labor hours for fabricating and 1 labor hour for finishing. Each type of B requires 12 labor hours for fabricating and 3 labor hours for finishing. For fabricating and finishing, the maximum labor hours available per week are 180 and 30. The company makes the profit of rupees 80 on each piece of type A and rupees 120 on each piece of type B. How many pieces of type A and type B should be manufactured per week to get a maximum profit? Make it a LPP, solve it graphically, and what is the maximum profit per week. Now, before going for it, let's try to make a table for it. Now, whatever we are having, we can make it in the form of a table. Now, we are having 9 labor hours for fabricating. Now, for fabricating, then finishing, hours, labor hours. Now, teaching aids we are having A and B. Then we are having profit. We can write it profit in rupees, one thing, and now maximum labor hours available. Maximum labor hours available. So this is the data, and we are going to fill a data for it. Now, 9 labor hours for fabricating and 1 labor hour for finishing. Then 12 labor hours for fabricating and 3 labor hours for finishing. Then we are having 180 and 30 available hours. 180, 30, and profit is rupees 80 and rupees 120. Now, this is the form of a table. Now, using this table, we can make formulating. Okay, now let's start it. Now, let we are having number of pieces manufactured of type A is equal to X, decision variable, and number of pieces manufactured of type B. Now, in place of pieces, we can write teaching aids also. Okay, one and the same thing. Now, number of pieces manufactured of type B is equal to Y. Objective function: maximize, because we have to find it what is the maximum. Okay, so maximize. Now Z is equal to, from the table we are having profit in rupees, that is 80x plus 120y. subject to constants. Now we are having first part 9x plus 12y is less than is equal to 180. Now this is fabricating constants. To this we can write it, or 3x plus 4y is less than is equal to 60. Equation number 1. Then we are having x plus 3y. X plus 3y is less than is equal to 30. Okay. So this is what? Equation number 2. Now this is finishing constant. Finishing constant. Number 3, non-negative constant. Or even we can write it non-negative restrictions. Is it clear? So now bounding the line to the corresponding inequations. Number equation number 1, 3x plus 4y is equal to 60. This becomes equation 4, and x plus 3y is equal to 30, equation 5. I have made a rough sketch. Now let's plot it. First of all, we are having 3x plus 4y is equal to 60. So 3x plus 4y is equal to 60. Now we are having, when y is 0, x is 20, and when x is 0, y is 50. So we are having 3x plus 4y is equal to 60. 3x plus 4y is equal to 60. And points are this one and this one. Okay. Then second equation, or you can say equation this one, x plus 3y is equal to 30. Now when y is 0, x is 30, when x is 0, y is 10. So we are having this point as 30, 0, and 0, 10, this one as 0, 10, and we have joined the points, we got a lines like this one. Now let point of intersection of equation 4 and equation 5 be capital B. This one now. Solving simultaneously equation 4 and equation 5, we get coordinates as coordinates for B is 12, 6. Okay, so this is point of intersection. Point of intersection. Now checking for feasible reason. Now, for equation 1. Now, equation 1 is 3x plus 4y is less than 60, less than is equal to 60. Now, so if we are putting here the point 5 comma 5, now 5 comma 5 means 15 plus 20, 5 times 3 15, 5 times 4 is 20, so it becomes 15 plus 20, that is less than 60. Okay, point 5 comma 5 satisfies the equation 1, therefore shade towards 5 comma 5. Now, equation was, first equation was 3x plus 4y is equal to 60, and 5 comma 5 lies here, so shading will be this side. Is it clear? Shading will be this side. Now, second equation was x plus 3y is equal to 30. X plus 3y is equal to 30. For equation 2, now equation 2 we are having x plus 3y is less than is equal to 30. Now, point. Now, here again you have to take a point. Again, we can take 5 and 5 only. 5 times x, that is 1. 5 times 1 plus 5 times 3. This becomes 20. 20 is less than 30. Okay. Or you can take any other point which should satisfy this point. Even you can take 0, 0 also. Okay. So, point 0, 0. I am taking 0, 0. You can take any point. But it should be satisfying this one. This it can be 2 comma 5, it can be 2 comma 8 also, okay, it can be 1 comma 9, it means any points you can do it. So, point 0 comma 0 satisfies equation 2, therefore shade towards the point 0 comma 0, that is origin. Then x greater than equal to 0, y greater than equal to 0, shade in first quadrant. Okay, so now for this line, our shading will be this side. Then our shading will be for y greater than equal to 0 and for x greater than equal to 0. Is it clear? So now, using these three, common feasible area will be, we are having now, so this is the common feasible reason. Now B was, point B was 12,6. So let me write it 12,6. Feasible reason is we are having now O, A, B, C and O. Is it clear? No. Corner point. R. Origin 0,0. A. A is 20,0. B. 12,6 and C. C is 0,10. Okay. Now corner points profit Z is equal to 80x plus 120y. Now 0,0, Z is equal to 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. Then A, 20,0, Z is equal to 20 times 80 plus 0 is equal to 1,600. B, 12,6, Z is equal to 80 times 12 plus 120 times 6, this is equal to 960 plus 720 equal to 1,680. Then point C, 0,10, Z is equal to 0 plus 120 times 10, 1,200. So maximum is which one? This one is the maximum. At point this point. Maximum value of Z is equal to 1,680 at point B, that is 12,6. Now final statement is, what they ask us, how many pieces of type A and type B should be manufactured per week to get a maximum profit? A manufacturing company will get maximum profit of rupees 1,680 when TeachigBharat of type A will be 12 items, sorry, 12 piece, let's write it piece, 12 piece, and teaching aid of type B will be 6 pieces, 12 and 6, and this is the answer.